Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss the topic is mock interview. Okay, let's see. We have 5 questions here. Before I am going to answer these questions, you just think once. Okay, let's go through a question by question. Can we include a Lightning web component in Lightning Aura component? First question. Then, how can you publish a platform events? How can you publish platform events? How can you subscribe platform events in Lightning component? In another way, to subscribe platform events, which component we have to include in Lightning component? Let's see. And another question is, can we enable single sign-on for communities? And which interface we have to implement for making an Aura component available to communities? So let's go one by one now. So I think you already think about it. So let's go through that. Let's match your answers and my answers. So, can we include a Lightning web component in a Lightning component? Yes. And you can't include a Lightning Aura component into the Lightning web component. Okay. So how can you include a Lightning web component in Lightning component? If you see here, Aura component and LWC Hello World is the web component. This is how you can include. So basically, when you are including a web component into another web component, you always use kebab cases. For example, it looks like this, like LWC, like this, right? So, but when you are going to include a Lightning web component into Aura component, you just need to use normal Lightning Aura component inclusion syntax. Okay, C colon, there is a default namespace, C colon, your web component name. That's it. This is a very simple thing. Okay, and again, I'm telling you, you can include a Lightning web component into Aura component, but you can't include an Aura component to web component for now. Okay, next question. How can you publish platform events? Basically, platform event is a part of streaming API, and you can publish platform events with declarative methods like with the process builder or flows and Apex code and APIs, either REST API or SOAP APIs. Okay, for now, let's see. So to publish a platform event through Apex code, what you have to do, you just need to prepare an instance of that event. In our case, it is opportunity actions event. Okay, in that we have fields, location, stage name, message. Okay, here I'm just assigning the values. To publish this event, you just need to use the event bus dot publish method. Okay, so basically until this, you are just preparing the event like our object creation. Okay, so here only, instead of insert statement, you have to use event bus dot publish method to publish your event. And process builder, this is also like in process builder or flow, you have to create this event like object creation simply. And you can try your own REST API. So first thing is, for publishing your component through APIs, either SOAP API or REST API. Here, I'm giving you an example through REST API. It is always the post method, and this is the endpoint URL for publishing an event. In our case, our event name is opportunity actions. And what are the attributes we have? Location and stage name and message. Okay, this is the request body. Method type is post. Then whenever we hit this service, then it automatically publish. Okay, so that means you can publish platform event internally in Salesforce Or otherwise, you can give this API to external system to publish these events when something happens. Then you can listen that event in Salesforce. Okay, this is how you can work with the platform event. Anyway, in the next classes, you will see a demos on platform events also. It's just a interview question. So let's go to another question. So how can you subscribe a platform event? For as I told you already, a platform event can be published in Salesforce, or it can be published through APIs from external system also into Salesforce. So here, for example, if you want to create a dashboard, or if you want to create a page for the notifications or real-time notifications to be shown on a page from platform events, then how can you show that platform events, or how can you show that notifications on Lightning component? First thing is, what component you have to include in that to process or to subscribe and to show the notifications? This is the one, Lightning EMP API component. You have to, EMP means here enterprise messaging platform, you have to include this EMP API component in your Aura component. Then you can subscribe to platform events and you can display that payload. Okay, payload means it's a message from Lightning, from platform event. Okay, how it looks like, you can go through this, then you can see that what it is. And now, this is the one. Can we enable a single sign-on for communities? Yes, you can enable. This is yes. The answer is yes. How can you enable? Okay, if you already enable a single sign-on on your organization, then you can enable the same single sign-on on your communities also, if you enable the communities. Okay, how can you enable? You just need to open a communities wherever you want to enable single sign-on and click on workspaces and select administration, or click on administration. Under administration, you can see this login and registration. Okay, when you click on this login registration, on that page you have a section login page setup. There you have two checkboxes. One is with the username password. Okay, it's with community username password. They can, your community user can log in, and along with that you can see your single sign-on checkbox also. Okay, you can see a single sign-on checkbox also with your single sign-on name. Then you just need to check that, then it will enable a single sign-on for your communities. Okay, that means not only in internal system or internal Salesforce instance, you can enable single sign-on on communities also. Okay, if it is authenticated communities. So let's go to next question. So basically we have different kind of communities. Okay, it may be just you are creating community for only reporting purpose only, you are creating community for showing the records, or you are customizing the community completely for your customers, for your external users. Okay, for everything, whenever you have that situation, whenever you have the more customizations, sometimes you need to include some Aura components also in communities. That means based on your customization, if you want to include an Aura component into your communities, first thing is your Aura component should implement an interface that is force community available for all page types. This should be implemented on your Aura component. Then only it will be available for adding into your community when you are working with the community builder. Okay, now this is how you have to enable an Aura component for communities. Okay, these are all the references. Please go through that. Here, the concept, the biggest concepts are, please go everything. One is about how to include Lightning Web Component in Lightning Component. So what is the need of including Lightning Web Component into Lightning Component? I'll give you one example that if you want to create a quick action, Lightning web component don't support quick action for now. Then what you do, you can include or you can embed this Lightning web component into Aura component, and you can specify this Aura component in the quick actions. So this is only one of the example. Not only for this kind of things, wherever you want to include ever, wherever Aura component supports but not Lightning web component, you can include or you can embed this Lightning web component into Lightning Aura components. Okay, and as I told you already, Lightning web component can be included into Aura component, but not vice versa. Okay, and platform events. Okay, if you don't know about the platform events, please go through the platform events. Okay, from Trailhead, you can get to know what is platform event. Okay, it is one of the streaming APIs. Basically, it will be very useful for you if you know what is platform event. A platform event will be useful for pushing the notifications or performing real-time notifications. Okay, so you can get to know more through Trailhead and subscribing. Okay, you can subscribe through, what is that? EMP API. Okay, and what else? This is communities, how to enable single sign-on, or can we enable single sign-on for our communities? And which interface we have to implement for making a Lightning component available to communities. One interface name is Force Community, available for all page types. These are all the references. You can go through that, okay, for a deep dive into each and every concept what we discussed in mock interview. Okay, please subscribe to Salesforce TechBook. All the best.